breaking news on that harrowing hostage situation in the African desert this morning. We have more information about an American killed by the Islamic militants, and we know several other Americans are in danger right now. ABC's chief investigative correspondent Brian Ross has been covering this story from the jump, and he's with us now with more. Brian, good morning.
Well, good morning, Dan. The death toll continues to climb, with at least one American and 11 other hostages reported to have been killed. The Algerian military now has twice stormed the natural gas facility, but authorities say the situation this morning is still not resolved and that a number of Western workers, including Americans, apparently remain hostages.
The State Department has now confirmed that 58-year-old Fred Butasio of suburban Houston was killed at some point during the attack and subsequent rescue efforts. But another American, Mark Cobb of Corpus Christi, Texas, is now confirmed as safe. His family says Cobb is the senior manager at the BP facility and sent a message to them, "I'm alive." The Al-Qaeda link group claims the attack on the facility in the middle of the Sahara Desert had been planned for some 2 months. In both assaults, the Algerian army, using tanks and helicopters, found the terrorists were heavily armed and prepared to fight to the death. One official described the aftermath as carnage. Hostages who escaped or were freed said the terrorists only wanted Westerners or Americans and were brutal in their treatment of some of them.
It happened so fast.
We were lucky that we are still alive and everything is good.
Another worker said he escaped as the terrorists tried to drive them to another location and the Algerian army opened fire on the convoy. American officials had urged the Algerians to go slow out of concern for the safety of the hostages.
They didn't let the terrorists dig in. They didn't negotiate. They moved quickly.
The attack has led the U.S. and its allies to marshal resources to track down the alleged mastermind, this man, Mokhtar Belmokhtar, who operates from a safe haven in the northern part of the country of Mali, 1,000 miles away. French military aircraft were already active here, even before the Algerian attack, according to ABC News correspondent Bazi Kanani in the capital.
There's much relief here in southern Mali now that more international help is coming in to fight the jihadists trying to take over the country. One of the first targets for the French warplanes that arrived a week ago was the headquarters of the leader of the terror group involved in the Algerian hostage crisis. The U.S. has said it won't send troops into Mali, but it is sharing intelligence with France. And by Monday, the U.S. Air Force will be helping to fly in French troops and equipment.
U.S. officials say they will now work with the French and others to make sure Belmokhtar pays a price.
Those who would wantonly attack our country and our people will have no place to hide.
Details about exactly what is happening this morning at the facility remain very sketchy, not only to reporters who are being kept about 20 miles away, but also to government officials in Washington, London, and Paris, who continue to urge the Algerians to make the safety of the hostages their first priority.
Yeah, I wonder if there's tension between the American government and the Algerian military this morning. Brian, thank you very much for your reporting. We appreciate it.
The situation there still remains such an information vacuum. It's so frustrating. Right.